Welcome back. My name is Chris, and I'm bringing you the November edition of NetSuite News. I have a lot of different things to talk about, so let's get straight into it, starting with the NetSuite certifications. Now, I already talked about this briefly in the October NetSuite News, so I'm not going to rehash everything, but just to quickly recap, NetSuite has recently rolled out a new certification system. So there's quite a few changes, but some things have stayed the same. Just a few days ago, I basically attended a webinar where they gave a lot more specifics about what was changing and what was staying the same. So I want to give you just a quick kind of run through of some of the most commonly asked questions. I will be coming out probably next week with a full length video diving into all the different aspects of the certification. But for now, let's just talk about some of the key ones. So as a quick recap, it used to be there was 5 functional certificates and 3 technical certificates, and they used to just be somewhat of a mishmash. It was a little hard to tell which ones you should do. Now they've created a tier system with a free associate tier, a kind of mid-level paid specialist tier, and then a more expensive professional tier. So all the certificates that existed, or I shouldn't say all, most of them have fit into that tier system. Some have been removed, some are still existing, and a lot of new ones have been added. All of the free ones are entirely new. So that's a kind of a quick concept of how they exist. So now let's cover the frequently asked questions, starting with, are my certificates that I already had, are those now invalid? And the answer is no, they're still absolutely valid. Even if they don't exist as certificates you can get newly, they're still valid as what you had previously. So anything you've already passed an exam for, you can still have that on your credentials. Then the next question was, what is happening with SuiteFoundation, the admin exam, and the ERP consultant? Because those still remain in the now new tier system, but how have those changed? And if I've been studying and preparing for them previously, am I still ready to take the new exam? And the answer is yes. Those exams have not changed. So if you've taken my prep courses, or if you've just been doing the Oracle MyLearn study route to prepare for, let's say, the ERP consultant exam, you're still totally ready for the exam. It has not changed in terms of its structure or the questions on the exam itself. The next big question that was asked was, what about the financial user and the Suite Analytics exams? Those were 2 certificates that previously existed that you cannot find now in the new tier system. And the answer is that those 2 certificates were then broken into multiple exams. For example, when it comes to the financial user, there's now several exams, such as accounts payable, accounts receivable, the accountant professional. So they exist in multiple tiers with multiple different certificates. I actually took the accounts payable exam last night just to get a feel for how the new certification process works. And all I can say is this, it's not that financial user as it existed was literally ripped into 3 different certificates. It's really they've got multiple new exams, and some of those overlap with the concepts that you found in the financial user. I have not found any literal overlap between questions from one to the next. So that means, at least from my standpoint, that those 2 prep courses that I had made for financial user and Suite Analytics are now no longer valid, and I'll have to come out with new ones for the new certificates. But again, if you did have financial user Suite Analytics already, those are still valid certificates. The next thing to keep in mind is there was previously a kind of like a link or a web form you could go to where you could put in somebody's name and it would show you all the certificates that they had, whether they were expired or still valid. That portal no longer exists, or at least they're going to be shutting it down within the next month. For whatever reason, Oracle has its own rules in relation to privacy settings, and it can't have its users with the certificates easily displayed, which I think is not a good thing, because now if someone wants to verify that you have credentials, the only way you can really do it is have those digital badges that you put in, like your email credentials, etc. So that's just kind of what you have now going forward. Another major question that came up in the webinar was, what about renewals on your certificates? Previously, it was just every year you have to do kind of a short quiz to get your certificates renewed. They're making the process a bit more elaborate now. So some certificates are going to have every year you renew them in a particular way. Other ones will have a 2 or 3 year window before you have to renew them. I'll get into the details on all that in my full length certification video. So we'll talk about that there. And then I saved the best for last. As part of this new certification system, they're coming out with a sort of a free coupon giveaway for anyone that's taking the new certificates from now until the end of the year, December 31st. There is no one watching this video that this doesn't apply to or who should not take advantage of this. So even if you're a seasoned consultant that has all of the old certificates, you still obviously don't have the new ones, and you can now take advantage of and take whatever four free exam takes you want. So four, you can either apply those to four different exams, or you could take the same exam multiple times if you wanted to. Those four free coupons do not apply to the certificates that already exist, like SuiteFoundation, ERP Consultant, etc. You will still have to pay for those. But if you want to get your accountant professional or accounts receivable, or your there's like a BI and reporting certificate, you can take that one for free. So again, if you're seasoned, you can take them. If you're a newbie, you should still take them, even if you consider that you're way too busy to properly prepare for an exam in the month of December. Let's say it's crazy for you. Totally fine. You should still sign up for and take the exams just sometime in the evening, on the weekend, whenever you can fit in an hour, hour and a half. Take the exams that you know you might want. And even if you flunk them, totally fine. You now can write down notes about the areas that you found you were weak on. And then when you have more time to properly prepare, let's say January, February, you can do so. But you didn't lose anything other than an hour and a half to take the exam. It's a low stress. You have nothing to lose opportunity. For free tries, I highly recommend you take advantage of those. So that is the new certifications. Again, I will come out with a video shortly fully diving into the certifications, but let's move on to our next segment, which is the super training highlight. Now in this segment, I usually talk about a recent course that I've come out with, but in light of what I just talked about with certifications, I wanted to particularly point out my SuiteFoundation prep course. As I just pointed out, the SuiteFoundation exam has not changed at all. And that prep course, which I only made a little over a year ago, still remains entirely relevant to that exam. It remains my most popular course, not just because a lot of people pay for it, but a lot of people have used that course to pass their SuiteFoundation. Even students who have never touched a NetSuite account, only using my prep course, have been able to get their SuiteFoundation certificates, which for a lot of people gives them the opening to then get a job where they're actually going to be utilizing NetSuite. So that course is available. I've also, in light of the fact that they've changed their pricing, I've reduced the price of my course down to $150. So if you want to get your certificates, whether it's SuiteFoundation, ERP exam, etc., I do have those prep courses still available. Take advantage of them. Moving on to the next subject is NetSuite Next. That's the big next-gen product that was released, or at least announced, at SuiteWorld just last month. And I already talked about that in October at length. The only thing I want to mention here is that last week I came out with a video specifically on NetSuite Next. So if you haven't already seen that, I highly recommend you check it out. NetSuite Next is going to completely change the NetSuite ecosystem moving forward. Now, it doesn't necessarily mean it's going to change it tomorrow. It might be several years before that change really comes to fruition, but it is going to happen. So if you are especially a professional in the NetSuite ecosystem, or an aspiring professional, which I think most people watching this video are in that category, then NetSuite Next is very relevant to your livelihood. So if you're interested in knowing what's happening with it, where it's come from, and what I think is going to happen in the future, then definitely check out that video. I'll have a link for it down below, as well as a link hopefully up in the top left corner. So check it out if you have interest in that. And the last segment we're going to cover in this video is the app of the month with Shepherd. Now, before I dive into it, quick history lesson. A year ago, I came out with a video on NetSuite's Field Service Management app, which is shortened to FSM. Now, FSM actually existed previously. It was called NextTechnic, and it was acquired by NetSuite and then re-released as a NetSuite product called NetSuite FSM. And so I made a full tutorial video on how that product works, et cetera, a year ago. Since that time, now that a year has passed, I've heard of a lot of clients that have tried to implement NetSuite FSM with no success. And there's a few reasons I think that is the case. First off, when NetSuite did kind of re-release the product as their own, they did a large marketing push as part of that. So you had a lot of clients that were then trying to implement NetSuite FSM, and it bottlenecked with qualified implementers. In other words, professionals who know how to actually work NetSuite FSM. And the reason it bottlenecked is not just because there was so many people trying to implement it, but because, and I even commented on this in my video last year, the NetSuite FSM product, although robust, if you want to customize it in any way, you need a developer who specifically knows how to work FSM. There's just the way the software is built, you need someone to go in, and even if you want to add a field, change a checklist, move forms around, any of that is going to require a seasoned developer specifically for FSM. And there's only so many people who know how to do that. So a lot of people trying to implement, a bottleneck of proper professionals, you get a lot of failed implementations. So that brings me now to this segment of the app of the month being Shepherd, is an alternative field service product to NetSuite's FSM. And I'm actually going to roll a little bit of B-roll footage just to give you a concept of how Shepherd's FSM looks and feels. So I'll roll that now. And while this is rolling, I want to lay out three things that I think really sets Shepherd aside from any of the alternatives, including NetSuite's FSM. So first off, almost as a counterpoint to what I just said, where NetSuite FSM is really hard to customize and kind of frustrating to do that, when you're dealing with Shepherd's FSM, it is something that an admin can go into and quickly learn how to make customizations himself. So if he needs to take a field off, crunch down a checklist, or add fields, add additional elements, all of that can be done by a normal administrator, much like NetSuite can be customized quite easily. So that is a major point that makes Shepherd easier to use, not just for the implementation, but also in terms of the maintenance of it. Second point I want to bring up is in terms of the mobile app itself. Now, as you can imagine, a field service app is predominantly used by the technicians, project managers, etc., that are in the field. And those people tend to not be the most technologically savvy. So the fact that Shepherd has a more intuitive, easier to use mobile app might not sound like a big deal, but if you imagine it, if they're dealing with NetSuite's FSM, where it's a little bit more clunky, it's not as tactile, you can create a problem where the technicians get frustrated with the software and then simply refuse to use it, or they start doing shortcuts that is not inputting the necessary information that management wants to be put in by the technicians. So by Shepherd having a cleaner UI that is just easier for the technicians, it's a little more intuitive, it's easier to work with, it then can be the make break between a failed implementation or an implementation that is actually utilized by the people in the field. And then the third element is the fact that in addition to field service, Shepherd also comes with a number of different additional modules and features, and one of them is a rental feature. So there are some companies that not only, let's say, sell a product to a customer and then service it, but there are instances where they may rent equipment or machinery to the client or customer, and they have technicians, et cetera, going out to that rental equipment. If you've got that rental element, you cannot handle that in NetSuite. There's just not a module to accommodate for that. Shepherd has that built in to the app. So that's a quick look at Shepherd's FSM app and why I consider it the app of the month. Again, in the near future, I'll most likely come out with a much longer full-length tutorial walking through the product, how to customize it, etc. And with that, it wraps up this particular edition of NetSuite News. So if you found this video helpful, please hit that like button, subscribe if you want to see more videos like this. And with all that in mind, I hope to see you in the next video.